Joseph in prison. When Joseph sat in prison, God again bestowed his mercy upon him. The keeper of the dungeon found pleasure in him and put him in charge of the prisoners. It happened at the same time that the chief baker and the chief cupbearer of King Pharaoh were serving sentences in prison for having given offense to the king. The baker was being punished because 3 dead flies had been found in the bread which was intended for the royal table, and the cupbearer because in the goblet which he had handed to the king, 3 flies had likewise been found. As Joseph entered their cell one morning, he saw that they both were very sad. So he asked, "Why are you so sorrowful?" And they answered, "We have had unusual dreams, and we do not know what they mean." "Well," said Joseph, "tell me your dreams. Perhaps I can explain them to you." Then the cupbearer began thus, "I dreamed that I stood before a grapevine. The vine had 3 branches. They grew and blossomed, and their clusters of grapes ripened. But I held Pharaoh's goblet in my hand, took the grapes and pressed them into the cup, and I gave it to Pharaoh." Then Joseph said to him, "The 3 branches are 3 days. In 3 days, Pharaoh will deliver you from prison and will put you back in your former office. But when you come before Pharaoh, think of me and attend to it that I too am set free. For I was stolen away in secret from the land of the Jews, and I have done no wrong here. In spite of that, I have been imprisoned." When the baker heard how well Joseph had interpreted the dream of the cupbearer, he began also to tell his. "I dreamed that I was carrying 3 baskets of baked goods on my head, and in the uppermost one was the best and finest things that were baked. Then a flock of birds came flying and ate up everything that was in the basket." Thereupon Joseph said, "The 3 baskets mean likewise 3 days. In 3 days, Pharaoh will have you hanged on a gallows, and the birds will devour your body." 3 days later, Pharaoh celebrated his birthday, and he gave a great feast to his laborers and servants. The cupbearer and the baker were taken out of the prison, and they were tried in public. The cupbearer had to defend himself first. He said, "In the moment when the unfortunate accident happened, I was holding the cup in one hand and pouring in the wine with the other, so I could not prevent the flies from falling into the cup." This explanation was very satisfactory to Pharaoh. They freed the cupbearer of the crime and put him back in his same office. Then the chief baker's turn came. He, however, could not plead anything as an excuse, for the flies had fallen into the dough while he was kneading it, so that he might have been able to take them out. Hence his guilt was clear, and he was condemned to death. On the very same day, Pharaoh had him hanged on the gallows, and the birds ate up his body. So both dreams were fulfilled as Joseph had interpreted them.